إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أحباب, we continue focusing on the imposter, the false messiah, the deceiver, that liar, the Antichrist, the one that Allah's Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given us so much information on him, so that our ummah being the final ummah, and he will come out during this ummah's time, that we will be able to protect ourselves from him. And if we recall, in that hadith, that was the hadith of Tamim radiallahu anhu, when he explained how his ship had gotten lost at sea and they ended up at the island. And in some narrations say that their ship was destroyed at sea because of that. And they were barely able to make it alive onto the island. And they had that hairy beast that was there. And when that beast had told them that there's this man, this person that's in the monastery waiting for you, that they were happy because they were afraid that the beast that was talking to them was perhaps some type of a demon, a devil. Well, we're going to go back to that conversation between that person in the monastery, which of course we all know that it's a Dajjal. In the conversation that he has with Tamim and the rest of the people that are with him. And Allah knows best how many were with him. These signs, Ahbab, are basically portents. As we'll come to see, these are indicators that his time is approaching, that his time is near. And perhaps, and Allah knows best, my analysis of these, is that when he asked about the first of them, and the response was in the negative, that he then starts working his way backwards in the sense of sequence, of chronological order. But Allah knows best. So in that hadith, we continue. And that hadith, by the way, was in Muslim. فَقَالَ يعني الدجال أخبروني عن نخل بيسان قلنا عن أي شأنها تستخبر قال أسألكم عن نخلها هل يثمر قلنا له نعم قال أما إنه يوشك ألا يثمر. So the first question that he asks them is with regards to the date palm trees, that farm of the area known as Baysan. Now, people who are from that area of your Palestine, of what was known as Sham as a whole, they can probably tell you specifically where that's located. I'm sorry that I can't. They ask, what specifically are you asking about it? He says, I want to know, is the farm still producing, are its trees still producing dates? They said, yes, abundantly. And he said, soon, it will cease producing. He then goes to the second question. أخبروني عن بحيرة الطبرية. قلنا عن أي شأنها تستقبر. قال هل فيها ماء؟ قلنا هي كثيرة الماء. قال أما إن ماءها يوشك أن يذهب. The second question deals with the Sea of Galilee or Lake Tiberias. He asks about it. They say, what specifically are you asking about it? He says, does it have water? And he says, it's abundant with water. He says, soon it'll be that its water will go. Subhanallah, if you look at some of the sources online already, they're saying that that sea is the lowest that it has been in 100 years. That all of what feeds into it has dried up. And they say that because the level of the water has receded so much that islands are appearing in it. And Allah knows best. The third, أخبروني عن عين زغر. قالوا عن أي شأنها تستخبر. قال هل في العين ماء وهل يزرع أهلها بماء العين. قلنا له نعم هي كثيرة الماء. قال نعم هي كثيرة الماء وأهلها يزرعون من مائها. The third question he's asking about is the spring known as Zughar. And it's also said that it's referred to as Ain Sultan. Again, all of these areas for the people that live there, they can probably tell you the details of it. Maybe the next time you travel, if you make an Umrah and after that you're able to go to visit, for example, Palestine, etc., maybe you can try to look these places up and see if anybody knows where they are. And again, they ask, what specifically are you asking about? And he says, does it still produce water? And are its people irrigating their crops and their lands with it? They said, yes, it's still abundant with water and the people are irrigating their crops with it. He then asks the final question. أخبروني عن نبي الأميين. ماذا فعل؟ قالوا قد خرج من مكة ونزل يثرب. قال أقاتله العرب؟ قلنا نعم. قال كيف صنع بهم؟ قلنا إنه قد ظهر على من يليه من العرب وأطاعوه. قال لهم قد كان ذلك؟ قلنا نعم. قال أما إن ذلك خير لهم أن يطيعوه. SubhanAllah, the final question they ask is about the unlettered prophet, the illiterate, the one who does not know how to read or write. Tell me about him. SubhanAllah, he asks about one, about two, about three. None of them have happened yet. He asks about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they say, yes, this one, yes, this we can tell you about this too. What about him? He's arrived and he's present and he made his hijrah from Mecca to Medina. So it wasn't that he had to go to a fifth and say, okay, tell me about this. It's almost as though the Dajjal is trying to determine how close his time is. And he asks, did the Arabs fight against him? The other half is that, or did they accept him? And their response was, of course, no, they fought against him. Well, what happened? He says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam conquered them and they have all submitted to him. Alhamdulillah, that for the most part, in that time, Jaziratul Arab was the peninsula that La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah was dominant and supreme. But of course, Ahbab, when we hear these words, dominance, supremacy, perhaps part of our thinking is that, you know, these words elicit meanings of power and, you know, violence and who knows what of stuff. When we look at him, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we know that he conquered the hearts of people. We know that nobody became Muslim by force. And that unfortunately, when the people of his own tribe and others fought against him, Allahu Azza wa Jal gave him permission to defend himself and to fight. And in doing so, Allahu Azza wa Jal blessed him to conquer the very people that were torturing and oppressing. So he says, did that really happen, that he conquered them and they submitted to him? They said, yes. He said, that is better for them that they've done this. That is better for them. SubhanAllah, the Dajjal, ya Ahbab, is only fulfilling the role that he has. And in this, like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam taught us about shaitan, sadaqa wa huwa kadhub. He'll speak the truth at times, even though he is the liar. And in this case, this imposter, this deceiver, this liar is speaking the truth when he said it is better for the people to believe and to follow him. Alhamdulillah that we have believed and that we continue to follow and emulate him in everything of his beliefs, his worship and his character. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Ask Allah Azza wa Jal for forgiveness and mercy, and also thank him for his blessings. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakin fih. Ala wa in asdaq al-hadithi kitabullahi azza wa jal. Wa khayra hadin hadi rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sharra al-umuri muhdathatuhah. Wa kulla muhdathatin bid'ah. Wa kulla bid'atin dalala. Wa kulla dalalatin fi nar. Ahbab, this hadith concludes as we're told. وطعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بمخصرته في المنبر وقال هذه الطيبة هذه الطيبة هذه الطيبة يعني المدينة ألا هل كنت حدثتكم ذلك فقال الناس نعم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم فإنه أعجبني حديث تميم لأنه وافق الذي كنت أحدثكم عنه وعن المدينة ومكة. Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, as he is finishing up telling them what Tamim had just said to him, and Tamim is present as a witness. He is there, he is an Arab, he is understanding what's being said about him in his presence. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام with his stick, with his staff, he basically hit his minbar that he was standing on. And he said three times, this is Taba, or this is Tayba, referring to the city of Medina, which is known by many beautiful names. And then he says to them, didn't I tell you about this before? Haven't I spoken to you about all of this? And their response was, yes. And he said, I like what Tamim said, because it corroborates what I have spoken to you about in the past. SubhanAllah, ya Ahbab. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right after that, in the end, he says, Ala innahu fi bahri al-Sham, oh bahri al-Yaman. Then he says, La bal min qibal al-Mashriq. Mahu. And this is used as an affirmation to confirm, to give certainty. And he says again, Bal min qibli al-mashriqi mahu, Bal min qibli al-mashriqi mahu. And he's pointing with his finger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says that he is in the Mediterranean Sea, or in the Arabian Sea? And then he says, no, he is in the east. And he's pointing with his finger in the east, saying, he's in the east, he is in the east. Ahbab, all of those are signs. And if we look back at the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam being 1400 years ago, we see that a long time has passed. And if the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim felt that he was going to come out in their time, and they did not have perhaps all of the minor signs that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam prophesied about having occurred, our scholars have said from centuries ago that they have all occurred right now. All that's left is for these major signs. Ahbab, when we look at all that is happening in the world, not that we should become depressed and overwhelmed and full of anxiety and anything of that sort, because we have to be certain that Allah is in control. But rather we should be grateful to Allah Rabbul Alameen that He has blessed us to be believers and that He has given us everything of what we need so that we can live our lives with discernment, that He has given us Al-Furqan. So that we will not be distracted by what glitters and what is of these material things. Rather that we will keep focused, laser sharp on Allah Rabbul Alameen as He's our ultimate goal. Living our lives for Him because He is our Creator, our Cherisher Subhan. Making sure that we find peace and happiness and delight in the worship of Him Subhan. And we do all of that emulating the best of the best, the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So that Ahbab, regardless of what happens in life, we know that we're going to have to die. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. But we want to make sure, Ahbab, that we have lived as believers and that we die as believers. And that's what the purpose of all of this is. So that we can be rest assured that we are prepared from now, every day of our lives, so that nobody is caught off guard. Nobody is caught off guard not having been prepared, not having taken things seriously. Because the Prophet ﷺ made it clear, when those signs come, they're going to come and they're going to be back to back, one by one. We have no idea what's going to lead into it, how that's really going to happen. So get out of your mind to think that I'm waiting for this or I'm waiting for that. These things that are in the authentic teachings, yes. But otherwise, to say somebody's going to see it in their dream, or we're going to see something in the stars, or the horoscopes are going to read, or the fortune tellers are going to say, all of that is baloney and hogwash. As Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullahi alayhi said, and I'll conclude, العلم قال الله وقال رسوله ما سوى ذلك وسواس الشياطين. He says, real knowledge is what Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger say. Everything else other than that is the influence and the tainting of what the devils are involved in. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. يا الله, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, that you bless us with all that is good and beautiful in this life and the best of it in the hereafter. Ya Allah, and that you save us from ever being punished in hell. Ya Allah, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, that you truly grant us beneficial knowledge in this life. Ya Allah, and that you help us to put that beneficial knowledge to beautiful deeds and actions. Ya Allah, and that you increase us in both so long as we're alive. Ya Allah, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, that you protect us by giving us that discernment, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to see the truth for what it is, Allah, so that we abide by it. Ya Allah, so that we see falsehood for what it is. Ya Allah, and that we abstain from it and stay far, far away from it. Ya Allah, and we beseech you and we pray to you and only you time and time again, Ya Allah, that you help us and protect us so that we never get confused between the two of them. Ya Allah, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, that you save us from the fitna of Dajjal and from every other fitna that is out there, Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, that you bless us to live as believers, to die as believers, and to come back to you well-pleased as believers, as your worshippers. Allahumma ya Rabbil Alameen, Ameen. Ya Allah, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, as you are the healer. Ya Allah, that you heal your worshippers all over the world, Ya Rabbil Alameen. and locally, Rabbil Alameen, Hamza Rizvi, Wasim Salam, Sayyid Zafan, Mrs. Azizul Haq, Rayhan Aslam, Afroza Hay, the Saiti family, Sabah Hamida, Kareem Hamdan, Ruknuddin Badin, Shahan Ar-Rahman, the mother of our dear brother Sulaiman, Basim Demirai, Rahimin Ahmed, Aftab Ahmed and Afzal Hafiz. Ya Allah, we ask you that you heal them all. Ya Allah, bestow health and wellness upon them. Ya Allah, miraculously heal them and everyone else of your worshippers. Ya Allah, we ask you, Rabbil Alameen, that you answer these prayers. It is only you that we worship. Ya Allah, because it's only you that we believe in. Allahumma ameen wa aqim as-salam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا استووا أقيموا صفوفكم. Let's do our best, Ahbab, to ensure that we're standing at a designated spot with our heels to the line so that our rows are complete as well as being neat and straight. We ask you, Ahbab, that so long as you're present in the building that you keep your noses and mouths covered with the masks, please. Still. Allahu Akbar. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين إهدينا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
Ameen. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul a'udhu bi Rabbin Nas. ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. الله أكبر. سمي الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله.
السلام عليكم. Just a quick short announcement. Give me 1 minute, please. Inshallah, we are going to have a halaqa tonight. Subject to developing good habits. It'll be given by Sheikh Mikhail Smith after Maghrib. So please attend that halaqa. Inshallah, you will benefit. Good news, inshallah, starting October 15th, on our premises, there will be a COVID testing facility available. Starting October 15th, it'll be a drive-through only, and it'll be between 1:15 to 4 p.m., inshallah ta'ala. Sister classes every Tuesday from 12:30 to 1:30 p.m. is going to be in person or virtual. It'll be given by Sheikh Ishpendam again, every Tuesday from 12:30 to 1:30. Second subject, heaven and hell, every Sunday between Maghrib and Isha again, given by our beloved Sheikh. Also, brothers, we provide social services to the family in the community. If you need help, please call our office, extension 120. Donate generously for your masjid. Jazakumullah khairan.